Hello, plant lover. I missed you. Today we're going to talk about pothos plant care. Pothos for me is one of those plants that I just think everybody needs to have. It's such a beautiful plant and such an easy plant. Let's get started with the sun requirements. First off, try to avoid direct sunlight on your pothos plant because the leaves could burn. Pothos really do best in a bright, medium, indirect light sort of situation. I would say that an east-facing window is an ideal location for most pothos plants, but they're really great plants because they actually have quite a wide range. So they can usually do bright indirect light all the way to low light. That's right, low lights. Pothos is a long, much-loved plant in the plant community because you can put them in a lower light situation that some other plants might not really be able to handle. Amazing. But something that you should really know is that different varieties of pothos plants are actually going to have different light preferences. So, for example, a pothos like the Epipremnum aureum here, the golden pothos that has a lot of green to its leaves, although it's variegated, or something like the jade pothos here, which has absolutely no variegation to it and is completely green, these plants are going to have a lot more surface area that is able to photosynthesize. Anything that's green on the leaf can photosynthesize. So these types of plants are very well suited to be placed in sort of a lower light situation because they've got a lot of that surface area that's going to help them capitalize on the sunlight that is there. Now, on the other hand, something like the Marble Queen pothos, which is an absolutely gorgeous variety, has so much less green on the leaves. I mean, most of it is honestly a much lighter sort of whiter variegation on this. So just looking at it, we can tell that this plant has a lot less surface area that's going to be able to photosynthesize. So if we were to take this plant and put it in a lower light situation, what we would probably actually find is that the variegation starts to change. It would start to fade, and we'd see a lot more green coming on these leaves. And if it were to push out any new leaves, they'd probably have a lot more green to them and less of this beautiful variegation that we absolutely love. And that's just because the plant really can't handle that lower light situation without having enough green on its leaves. So what we see with the Marble Queen pothos is that it's going to have a much more limited lighting range. So the jade and the golden pothos might be able to do bright to low light. The Marble Queen is probably going to be happiest within sort of a medium light range. Why is it that the beautiful ones are always so temperamental? So if you have a variegated pothos and you're noticing the variegation fade into green, it needs more light to keep its variation. So bring it closer to the window. On the other hand though, with something like this, if it's too close to the window and it's getting too bright light, you could actually see the leaves go really pale and maybe even slightly yellow, and that just means that it's getting too much light, so pull it back. Now let's dive into watering. The most important thing to know about watering a pothos is that it is much more detrimental for a pothos to be overwatered than it is to be underwatered. Pothos can handle a little bit of neglect, but they cannot handle too much love. Make sure to let the soil completely dry in between waterings. And to check this, you can either stick your finger in the soil to see if it's dry, you can always lift up your pot to see if it's light, or you can do what I do. Basically, all I do is I watch my plant to see when the leaves just start to droop ever so slightly. At that point, I know it needs a drink and I give it a really, really good soaking. Now, if you leave it for longer, they will absolutely completely flop down. I don't like to let it get to that point, just a slight drooping, and then I'll water my plants. Although I love to give rainwater to pretty much all of my houseplants whenever I can, pothos really don't care what kind of water you use, so feel free to use tap. Onto the soil. They're really not too picky about the soil type, but I really recommend that you give them something well draining just to make sure that it doesn't get root rot. For fertilizer, honestly, they really don't need much fertilizer. I still do give them a boost of fertilizer just in the springtime to get them going for their growing season, but other than that, I don't fertilize. When it comes to pests, pothos are great because they are pest resistant. They're not pest proof. You could still see mealy bugs, spider mites, or scale, but for the most part, they are pest resistant, which just makes them a fantastic plant. For toxicity, pothos are toxic to both humans and pets. Now, it is very rarely ever a fatal encounter, but it could give you a really bad upset stomach. So, you know, don't eat it. When it comes to propagating this plant, pothos are so easy. All you have to do is take some stem cuttings, make sure that you've got a node on there, plop them in some water, and in a couple of months, you'll have plenty of roots to pot them on. Pothos are just really, really great plants, and they have the ability to instantly bring those jungle vibes into your home. I would absolutely love to know your favorite pothos varieties and your care tips, so go ahead and put those down in the comments below. I really hope that this video was helpful for you. My name is Sam, this is Mind the Leaves, urging you to take care of your plants and yourself.